hope you all are fit and fine at your places. So kids, our today's video is based on chapter 9, Changing Families. As you all know that we have completed chapter 9, part 1. And today we will discuss part 2. Now kids, in this chapter, I have told you that we will discuss about the three kids, Nimmi, Sering, and the third one is Nazli. So, in our previous video, which was part 1, we have discussed Nimmi. Now, in today's video, we will discuss Sering's family and Nazli's family. Means, we will discuss that what are the changes occur in Sering's family and Nazli's family. So kids, let's start our video. Now firstly, we will talk about Sering. Sering's father has got a letter from his boss. Yes, Sering's father has got a letter. And from whom his father got his letter? From his boss. Obviously kids, you know that whenever you work in an office, there is a boss and he used to take care of all the promotions and transfer. So from the boss, Sering's father has got the letter. Now, what this letter belongs to? Yes, Sering's father had got promoted. Now kids, what is the meaning of promoted? See kids, promoted means having one rank up. See, in office there are many ranks like clerk, PO, manager. So, Sering's father has got one position up, means one rank up, and he has got promoted. So, Sering's father, boss, has given that letter, and that letter means he has got promoted. Yes. Now, due to this promotion, Sering's father had to move to another city. Yes, due to this promotion, they have to move to another city, or you can say a new city. Yes, this is the main reason of the change. Due to this promotion, means getting one rank up, Sering's father has to move to a new city. Unhe ek nayi city mein jana padega. So, when Sering's father show his letter to his family, how his family member reacts? Uske family members ne kaise react kiya hoga? See, some members will be happy because it's a happy situation. Sering's father has got one rank up, he has got promoted. But side by side, they also feel sad. Now, why sad? Because they have to move to a new city and they have to leave their old city. Yes, because dear kids, whenever you live in a place, you get attached to that place. Yes, whenever you live in a place, you get attached to that place. Yes, you remember that place a lot. So when Sering will move to a new city and his family members also, so they will remember their old city. Yes, old place. So there was both of these situations. They are feeling happy also because his father had got promotion, and they are feeling sad also because they have to move to a new city now. Now kids, after understanding the change in Sering's family, we will do some activity. Yes kids, we will move to an activity now. Now kids, you can see the activity in the left side. See, in this activity, we will do some questions and you will learn about Tsering's family more. Now, in this activity, you have to write the change which occur in Tsering's family when his father got transferred. Now, what is the meaning of transfer? Transfer means moving in a new place. Now, due to promotion, as I have told you, that Tsering and Tsering family members are moving in a new city. So, moving in a new place means transfer. Now, the first question, who from Tsering's family will live with his father? Yes. Now, kids, you can see the pig. Who from Tsering's family will live with his father? In the pig, you can see Tsering. Tsering's mother and Tsering's, you can see Tsering, Tsering's mother and sister. Now you can see Tsering's grandmother and grandfather also. But in the picture, they are doing bye. Yes, they are doing this to Tsering and his father and mother. This means that they are not going with Tsering, his mother and sister. Which school will Tsering go to now? So the answer is Tsering will go to a new school. Yes, Tsering will now move to a new school and he will move to a new city. He will take admission in a new school. Now the next, will he have new friends? Yes, of course, he will have new friends. Now the next question, has anybody in your family moved to a new place? Now this question is a self question. Now ask to your mother or father, has anybody in your family moved to a new place? You can write this, yes, my uncle had moved to a new place, which is Delhi. Now, what do you feel about this change? Means, these changes are good or bad? See kids, a change is very important in one's life. Yes, the life should change because changes bring happiness in your life and it gives you the opportunity to work hard and get success. Now kids, we will move to Nazli's family. Yes, it's a wedding. Now we will talk about a change which has came in Nazli's family due to a wedding ceremony. Nazli. Now we will talk about Nazli's family. Now in Nazli's family there is one wedding. Yes, a wedding is going on in Nazli's family. Now, who is getting married or whose wedding is there in Nazli's family? Now, wedding is of elder cousin brother. Yes, the wedding is of elder cousin brother. Cousin brother means kids, son of uncle and aunt. So, in Nazli's family, there is one wedding and whose wedding it is? It is wedding of elder cousin brother. Now, you can see in the picture kids that there is a new, yes. When his elder cousin brother will got married, there will be new bride. Yes, there will be new bride means this is a new family member. A new family member. Remember, when his elder cousin brother will get married, there will be a new bride, and that new bride will be a new family member in Nazli's family. And what his elder cousin brother will call? See, elder cousin brother will call a bridegroom. When he will get married, he will call as bridegroom, and his wife will call as bride. Bride and bridegroom. So in Nazli's family, there is a new family member, and that family member is Nazli's sister-in-law. That new family member is Nazli's sister-in-law. Means this new bride is sister-in-law of Nazli. Now kids, we will do some activity. We will do some questions. So the first question is, do you think that there will be a change in Nazli's family? Yes, there will be a change in Nazli's family. And what will change? See kids, a new family member is added. A new family member is added to Nazli's family, and Nazli got a new sister-in-law. Yes, Nazli got a new sister-in-law. Nazli got a new sister-in-law. So this is the change which occur in Nazli's family. A new family member, and Nazli got a new sister-in-law. Now kids, a new question. Do you think there will be a change in the home from where the new bride has come? Yes. See, the home of new bride, the previous home of new bride. Yes, we are talking about the home of this new bride. So yes, there will be a change in her home, as her father and mother will miss her a lot. Yes, when a girl comes to a new place, when a girl get married, her father and mother misses her a lot. Yes, they miss her a lot, they remember her a lot. So kids, with this topic we have studied that how the changes occur in everyone's family due to many reasons. See, the first reason of Nimmi was birth of a baby child. Second, Sering's reason was promotion of his father. And the last, Nazli, is wedding. So there are many reasons due to which changes occur in our families. Now kids, the last topic which we will talk about is marriage law. See kids, what is marriage law? In this marriage law, the government has fixed some age of getting married. Yes, a boy can get married after 21 years. And a girl can marry after 18 years only. So these are the two ages which the government has fixed. And kids, in many places, kids are getting married. Means the people used to marry them before the age of 18 and 21. And this is illegal. This is prohibited. Yes, this is wrong. The government has fixed the age of marriage. A girl should get married after 18 years. And a boy should get married after 21 years. And this is a law. This is a law. Law means kanoon hai ye. So with this kids, we have ended our chapter. Chapter 9, Changing Families. And now moving to activity corner.
Page number 70. Is there anyone in your class or school who has come to your school from another place? If so, talk to him or her. Kids, this exercise, this activity, you have to do by your own. First question, where has she or he come from? means from Delhi, from Punjab, from Maharashtra. You have to write the place where he or she come from. What was his or her old school like? Means how is his or her old school? Means it was green or it was big, it was beautiful. What does he or she find different here? Next, does he or she like the change? Means if they are liking the change, then yes, otherwise no. So kids, this activity you have to do by your own. Now kids, page number 72. Now in the above questions, you have to talk to your mother and aunt and you have to ask them that where they lived before they got married. Who were the family members in their family? And has anybody in your family been married recently? And who has married recently? Recently means few days before. Now, next activity. Talk to your classmates and write all about what happens during weddings in their families. Now, the first question. What kind of special food is cooked? A variety of traditional foods was cooked along with sweets. What special clothes do the bride and bridegroom wear? Bride, lehenga and choli with dupatta. Bridegroom, sherwani and pagdi. What kinds of songs and dances are performed at weddings? Traditional, folk, melody and modern songs and dances. Page number 72. Now we have to write the reasons for the changes in Nimmi, Sering and Nazli's family. The first, in Nimmi's family, the change happened because of the birth of a new baby. They got a new family member. In Sering's family, Sering's father got a promotion at work and had to shift to a new city. Page number 73. In Nazli's family, as her elder cousin brother got married, a new bride came to Nazli's family. She was Nazli's sister-in-law. Next, there can be many reasons for changes in families. Can you think of some more reasons? First, death of a family member. Transfer of a relative who might come to live with the family. Third, leaving of a family member for higher education. Page number 73. Now kids, this activity is a self-activity. In this activity, you have to take three old people. One from your family, one from your friend's family, and one from a family in your neighborhood. And you have to ask these questions and you have to fill in the table. Page number 75. Going back to school. Now kids, this is a self-activity in which you have to write about yourself. The first, up to which class do you want to study? Up to which class have your parents studied? Till which class did your grandmother get a chance to study? In this question, you have to ask from your grandmother. At which age did your grandmother get married? In the last question, have you heard of a law that talks about the ages before which girls and boys must not get married? Yes, I have heard it, and by that law, boys before the age of 21 and girls before the age of 18 must not get married. Page number 76. Find out and write. Are there any such children in your neighborhood who had to drop out of school? Drop out means who have left the school. Do they want to go back to school? Yes, there was a boy in my neighborhood who had dropped out of school due to family problems. Means the boy has left the school due to family problems. He badly wants to get back to school. Next, what are they doing these days? He is working to provide food for his family and he is the only male child of his family. Has anybody in your family got married recently? Who? Yes, my elder cousin got married recently. What was the age of bride and the groom? The age of bride was 24 and the age of bridegroom was 30. What kind of dresses they wore? Bride, a beautiful lehenga choli with green dupatta. Groom, a classy sherwani and pagdi. What kind of dishes were there? Name them. Pulao, dosa, curries, jalebi, gulab jamun, idli, etc.